another book review, and we are reviewing Forever Never by Lucy Score. Okay, so this book caused me to go into almost a 6-month reading slump. Here's the issue. I read Lucy Score before. I read her by a thread, and I should have known that this book would probably do it because I read that book, and then I read a couple other books, and then I saw this book, and I was like, oh, I kind of enjoyed By a Thread. It was cute a little bit. Let me read another one. I respectfully do not like books where I feel as if it's a frame and all the person kind of does is switches out names, switches out jobs, switches out locations, and it's basically the same kind of story, the same kind of formula. That's what I feel this is. And I got a good, I did not finish it. I couldn't. I got about this far in. I got pretty halfway, almost basically finished the book. So here's my thing. It reminded me too much of By a Thread. You know, the big brooding male, the sassy, spicy female who's in trouble, who needs him to save her and get her out of trouble. Even though it's not really a big kind of trouble, it just really seemed like she changed names, changed location, and it was kind of the same story. A lot of it was predictable. Oh, you know, he's so serious and, you know, by the book. Whereas she is all, oh, I'm bubbly and this and that, but really not. She's more, oh, I'm independent, I can do this and that, but she's really submissive. I couldn't. I was even on the fence about doing a review about it. Because don't get me wrong, I like Lucy's Score. I sort of like the way she writes. I like the flow. But I don't have the excitement to read a lot of her books because I feel like a lot of them are going to be the same. Just a change of a title, change of this, and change of that. You know, easy fix type of things. Easy editing. Would I honestly recommend this to someone else? If they've never read a Lucy Score book, I would recommend it because it does have good qualities. Like if this was my first book of hers, I probably would have enjoyed it and I probably would have finished it. But since this is not my first time reading her book, I didn't like it. And that's to put it nicely, I just didn't like it. It wasn't like, if I had to rate it 1 out of 5, was it terrible? No, it was solely because I had read By a Thread, and I was like, ooh, I'm going to read another Lucy Score book. And this was like within a 6-month period of between the two. But it was too similar. It wasn't anything different. It wasn't anything memorizing. I had put it down multiple times because there was nothing bringing me back to it. Because again, it felt like I had already read it. Again, if you are interested in the book, I guess this is your first Lucy Score book, read it. It had some cute moments. It had some comedy in there. It had some cute stuff. It had great potential. If you've read Lucy Score before, you don't need to read it because you read it before. And that's to say it nicely. So, Brick Callan and Remi Ford, I don't know how your story ends. I just wasn't interested in it. The fact that it was a brother's high school sweetheart, your boss's daughter, and your ex-wife's best friend type of thing. When you read it, you're just like, I don't know. Age gap romance, boss's daughter, like all those things that were, like all those labels, it really wasn't even that much of a thing. In the book, like, it was kind of like an afterthought. Again, if you've read her book before, you kind of know what it is. It's kind of like a book of checking off boxes. So, spice level, a 1 out of 10, 7. It was a 7. Most of the time, the spice that was in there, I'm like, okay, we were basically at a grocery store, and now we're, you know, spicing it up. It is some of the times it didn't even call for spice. So, yeah, that's my review of Forever and Ever Lucy Score. Oh, side note, I talked to my best friend about it, and she agreed, because she's read some of her books, and she was like, yeah. No, so there's my book review of Forever and Ever by Lucy Score. Thank you for watching. Hopefully you subscribe. If you don't, I get it. Who honestly really subscribes anymore? But if you do want to watch another book review, I would appreciate that. So thanks.